Early voting in four key local elections is over tonight. And as reporter Brian Stewart says, the results could be a key indicator in how many people decide to vote tomorrow. Brian?
Yeah, that's right, Julie. There's four critical mayoral elections in Atlanta, Gainesville, Danielsville, and Commerce. And across the board, the story is the same: low voter turnout, the lowest in years, actually. Take Gainesville, for example. They've seen a steady decline in voter turnout for nearly a decade. Charles Alvarez, Danny Dunnigan, Deborah Harkrider, and Rose Johnson are trying to become Gainesville's first elected mayor ever, but precincts have remained empty. Early voters just aren't interested.
I think it's kind of fallen by the wayside, and it can't really be explained because it certainly hasn't been because of availability and accessibility.
The city of Gainesville isn't the only one that's experiencing these declines. The mayoral race in Danielsville between incumbent Todd Higdon and former Mayor Philip Croya has seen a drop, too. Their population is only 560, and their turnout topped out at just 43 people, down from last year. And down the road in Atlanta, early voting for these four candidates is way down compared to last year. This year, just under 82,000 people have cast votes for the mayoral election. Last year, in a presidential year, 1.8 million people had already voted by this time. So tomorrow's election day, citizens will have to choose between action and apathy. Now, we'll have to wait and see if those votes are tabulated. Nothing's been counted yet. So we'll just have to wait and see after tomorrow's elections who brings home all that office cash. Live in the newsroom, I'm Brian Stewart.
Thanks, Brian. For all your election coverage, be sure to visit our website at gradynewsource.uga.edu.